If you're a Christian, stand up. And that's what a gunman said to his victims yesterday. And if you stood up, he shot and killed you.
Well, today, that Oregon community is in mourning as authorities are trying to figure out more about the killer and why he did it. George Thomas has the story.
The reported gunman left an extensive digital footprint on blog sites and other online forums. This is Chris Harper Mercer's profile picture, taken from his MySpace account holding a gun. On one internet site called Spiritual Passions, he described himself as not religious, but spiritual. He didn't like organized religion and said, "I'm looking for someone to share my beliefs." He used similar language when he said online that he was looking for a woman who was pagan, Wiccan, not religious, but spiritual. The father of a wounded victim told CNN that Mercer reportedly ordered students to stand up and asked if they were Christians. And they would stand up, and he said, "Good, because you're a Christian, you're going to see God in just about 1 second." And then he shot and killed them.
We've got multiple gunshot wounds.
The rampage started late Thursday morning.
I hear screaming after that first gunshot.
In the small town of Roseburg, some 3 hours south of Portland, Oregon.
A lot of my classmates were just going every which way.
Students trying to take cover and hide.
We heard shots and immediately took cover. Went down and heard just multiple shots, a lot of screaming.
Officers on the scene confronted the 26-year-old shooter.
Officers engaged that suspect. There was an exchange of gunfire.
Mercer was shot dead, but not before he murdered 9 victims, 10 including himself. 4 weapons were recovered from the scene.
This doesn't happen in Roseburg. This is small town America. It's not supposed to happen here, but it happens.
Within hours of the shooting, President Obama called a press conference to demand new gun laws, saying that gun violence is, quote, something we should politicize.
Somehow this has become routine. The reporting is routine. My response here at this podium ends up being routine. The conversation in the aftermath of it, we've become numb to this.
Meanwhile, the FBI and other law enforcement officials are now combing through Mercer's emails and online activity, trying to figure out a motive. George Thomas, CBN News.
Well, our hearts go out to the survivors and to the families of these victims. What an incredible tragedy. And you just don't have words for it. And you wonder, are we just sheep given up for the slaughter? Has God removed that which restrains from our culture? That verse keeps running through my head, that there will be a day where he removes that which restrains. And are we living in that day today? What do we need to do as a people? I believe we need to turn to God. We need to ask him to restore his blessing on America. He needs to restore that which restrains so that we can live in a peaceful society. That wonderful little town, Roseburg, will it ever return to what it was before? And will America, the wonderful nation of the United States of America, can we ever return to what we were before? Where we lived in peace with one another. Can we ever have those days again? We can if we turn. The only peace that we will ever have is when the Prince of Peace reigns in our hearts and we acknowledge him once again as the source of all our blessing. Let us not forget the rock that we were hewn from, our nation founded to be a city on the hill. Let us not forget that. And let us turn so that we have it again.